Welcome back students for the second session of science chapter 3 synthetic fibers and plastics. Plastic is also a polymer like the synthetic fiber. Okay, all plastics do not have the same arrangement of units. In some it is formed in linear, whereas others it is formed cross-linked. You can see in the image, that first image, it is shown a linear arrangement, like one chemical unit is behind the another and it is forming a long chain. And in the second image, you can see that how it is in crisscross arrangement has been made. And you know why it is so popular in plastic is so popular, because it is easily moldable in all types of possible shapes. Plastic can be recycled, can be colored, reused, rolled into a big sheets, or made into wires. It can also be used in making toys, suitcase, bags, cabinets, brush, chairs, tables, and many other countless items. As we know in our daily, day-to-day life, how much we are using a plastic. Now, polythene is one of the most famous examples of plastic, which is used in manufacturing of carry bags. You know, when you are going to the shop or when you want to buy something, the shopkeeper gives us in the polythene bag. Or carry bag. Now the second part is, that is types of plastics. Plastic is again divided into two parts, that is thermoplastic and thermosetic. Such plastics which get easily bent or deformed on heating are known as thermoplastic. For example, if you take a hot water and if you take your water bottle or a simple bottle and if you pour water on it, you can see that it is getting melted or it is the shape has been changed. So such type of delicate plastics are said to be thermoplastic. We can see PVC and polythene. PVC, you can see that wires, or we can see pipes. PVC pipes, we can see where you water the plants, that is said to be PVC material. It is used in making toys, bottles, combs, etc. Now comes the thermosetting plastics. Such plastic which mold once, okay, cannot be softened or deformed by heating. These are called thermosetting plastics. You can see, take the example of cooker handle, that is made of thermosetting plastic, and if you put hot water or something, it will not bend, it will not have any effect on the heat. Now again it has been divided into two parts, that is bakelite and melamine. Okay, so these plastics are used in, okay, bakelite and melamine are used in making hard boards, electric switches, handles of electric appliances, handles of kitchen utensils, floors, etc. Now we'll come to melamine. Okay, melamine is a versatile material and poor conductor of heat. It resists fire. Poor conductor of heat means that it is having a resistance to fire. It is an all-rounder, we can say. When we say versatile, it is an all-rounder material. Thus, it is used in making floor tiles, kitchen materials, fabrics, which resist fire. Another type of thermosetting plastic is bakelite. It is also a poor conductor of electricity and heat. So, it is used for making electrical switches, handles of various utensils and other electric appliances. You can see when switches are there, okay, why we are using switches with this bakelite material, so that you will not get shock and it is having that resistive power. Now plastic as a material of choice, why everybody is choosing plastic? You can see, you can store many things in plastics, okay, and reason is that it is very light, okay, lower price, good strength and easy handling, being lighter as compared to metals. So plastics are used in cars, aircrafts and spacecrafts too. So when you are going, why you are going for plastic? Because when you are storing all these items in this thing, it is easy to carry also, it is easy to maintain also. So that is why it is a material of choice. The characteristic of properties of plastic. Plastic is non-reactive. Plastic do not react with water and air. That is why it does not get rusted like iron. Okay, you don't know how iron gets rusted when it is come in contact with air. Okay, because in the air you will have that humidity, okay, that wetness you will find. That is the reason it gets rusted. So these things doesn't affect plastic. Okay, they are not corroded easily. They don't get rusted. That is why they are used to store various kinds of material, including many chemicals. You must have seen or you must have heard that in chemical industries also they have a very big containers, plastic containers, where they keep all chemicals in there. Because you know when they keep the same thing in aluminium or in metal or in steel, that it cannot have that resistance power, so it gets rusted and it will spoil the thing. So here the chemical is intact, no problem with the chemical, and in the container also is okay. Due to this property of plastic, it is suitable for making of container, water tank, water bottle, plastic pipes, taps, chair, table and other types of furniture. Plastic is light and durable. Plastic is are lightweight. Okay, we have all discussed this. Durable means long lasting. It is very cheap, very low cost. It is very strong. It is having and can be molded into different shapes and size as we have studied earlier. Due to this property of plastic, it is very much in need today. It is used for various purposes like polythene bags or pencil box, water bottle or umbrella, furniture or aircraft. The use of plastic can be seen everywhere. So why these are the properties, okay, why we are using plastic? Plastic is also are poor conductors. Plastics are poor conductors of heat and electricity. Okay, so due to this property of plastics, it is suitable to make insulating covering of electric wires. You can see the wire, okay, any wire, you must be have seen some covering over there, that is a insulating covering. Handles of electric appliances, handles of utensils, handles of screwdrivers, kitchenware, floor tiles and etc. Some uses of plastics in various fields. Okay, when we come to hospitals, we just refer it as a health industry. Plastics are used for packaging of tablets, threads, using for stitching wounds, syringes, doctors give gloves and a number of medical instruments. Special plastics cookware is used in microwave oven for cooking food without affecting the plastic vessel. You have seen you are in at home in when your mom is going to the shop for buying something, they specifically ask that they want a container or a thing to keep in the microwave oven for cooking. So it is a special type of container is coming for that microwave oven. Now we come to Teflon. Now you have seen these also at your home when you are buying a frying pan or non-stick pan. In that you will be having a label said to be Teflon. So it is a special plastic, okay, that layer is special plastic on which oil and water do not stick. It is used for making non-stick coating on cookwares. Now we have discussed that it is also used in fabrics. We will see where we are using in fabrics. Fireproof plastics, that is synthetic fabric, catches fire easily. So the uniform of firemen have coating of film, melamine plastic to make them flame resistant. So that is why they are saved or they have resistant power, that for when they are putting off the fire and all, they wear that dress. Now comes the biodegradable and non-biodegradable thing. Okay, a substance which gets decomposed through natural process. Such an action by bacteria is called biodegradable. That means anything which is decomposed, okay, which is get rotten by the attack of microbacteria or microorganisms, anything, and it goes back to the soil or goes back to the nature, it is said to be biodegradable. For example, peels of vegetables, foodstuffs, fruit paper, cotton clothes, wood, etc. Now comes to the non-biodegradable substance. Now what is that? A substance which is not easily decomposed, okay, which does not get rotten, it remains for years, does not get decomposed by natural process like by the bacteria attack, is termed as non-biodegradable. Example, aluminium, plastic, etc. So how it is affecting the environment? Okay, plastic is a non-biodegradable material. it takes many years to get decomposed or either does not get decomposed. So due to biodegradable property of plastic, it is a very major problem for environment. So students, so next session we will be learning how different types of biodegradable things are there and non-biodegradable things, and what are the five uses of our, or what are the five principles of